Hey guys, it's Rookie Careers, and welcome back to my favorite 16 Liverpool Crowbar, where I last off. I qualified for the next stages of the Champions League. In this episode, I have games against Norwich and Crystal Palace in the league. But this is also a very special day because this is going up. This is being recorded and going up on the 28th. Of February, which means it's the day of the Capital One Cup final between Liverpool and Manchester City. Now, pretty amazing that Jurgen Klopp has taken a squad he hasn't made that much changes to. He hasn't made any real sign. Things to improve the first team that are his signings. You know, say for her sign three guys, two who won't be coming until the summer, and Calker, who's only being used as a substitution. So he's taken pretty much Brendan Rodgers' team from useless to a final, despite the fact that their defense is still useless. If he can do that 4 months, roughly 4 months after taking over, without making any solid and recognizable and improving change to the squad, imagine what he can do once he does make some improvements. Once he does improve the team. If he can get to a final with what he has. Even if our defense is terrible right now, he's going to improve that once he gets the chance in the summer. And the future will be very bright indeed. Hopefully, he can start off with a trophy and set everything rolling on a nice little start. Everything with a nice little winner's medal, a nice trophy. Sorry, I hit the mic there. But yeah. If we can exploit Manchester City, we can beat them. I truly believe Liverpool will win today. Of course, I hope they win every game, but they don't normally do that. But let's get the feeling. I have a good feeling that today will be their day.
What we've been waiting for. The kickoff, the game is underway. Well, this lineup is very different for Norwich City from the one when they last played. Martin Olsen starts, despite looking.
So let's get stuck in here and start off this day. Be right.
Here's
Nathaniel Klein.
The opposition.
Rain. Tiemans.
Towards Bale. Royce! He's missed it.
Oh, Royce couldn't put it in. He hit it too hard. All I needed to do was tap it in. Coutinho. Ah, Martin with a good tackle. But they're doing that stretch to Coutinho. Rodriguez. Marco. Royce. Neymar! Top corner, very nice. of course, in the last episode, Neymar also overtook Correa and is now the leading top goal scorer. He's just extended his lead at the top. He was one goal ahead, now he's two.
And Liverpool are in front in this game, and there's no surprise in that.
Well, it's a nice bit of skill, but the defending, well, it was woeful.
Some cut out my attack just as I was about to shoot. What is dickhead?
Challenge between the two of them there.
Come on. Ball off him. Nope. No, that's not going to happen. Okay, fair enough.
Olsen.
Come on, Ricardo, for fuck's sake. Try hard, that man.
Coutinho.
Bale. So why Bale was playing very... He's coming in very central. Ooh. Well, that's the second time I found him where someone like Tielemans should be.
Royce. A problem until the clearance was made. Gareth Bale.
Bale.
And in goes the cross. Neymar!
Neymar! From one Serie A? From one league. From one La Liga play to another. Bale crosses it in. Neymar, bottom corner. Or talk about being precise with the header. It's on point. 15th minute and the 31st minute. Am I going to score another one? The hat trick coming to the 45th minute. What are they? What would the odds of that actually be? Correa. It's
cleared. The team on top of its game. It's certainly been reflected in the results, and it's a run of victories, a massive run of victories.
I'm not sure how much he knew about it, but he's lost the ball. He's
capable of beating them. They look formidable.
Martin Olsen.
Demands.
Stephen Whittaker.
Porte.
Nathaniel
Clark.
He's seen a pass, cut it.
I should have saw that. Yes, didn't matter anyway. He brain cut out their pass. Two men. Was that overhit? Nope. Both made it there.
End the threat, at least for the moment. Keep on Bolstinkel. Jakob.
There's the halftime whistle. I didn't get the hat trick of the 45th minute. Chelsea, who are currently second, are 0-0, which is good. See them drop some points. Doing fantastic. There's Bale.
He's beaten his man.
Correa, right, he is equal to it.
Goalkeeper doesn't have to move.
Laporte.
The presentation of the Barclays Premier League fixture. Norwich City, they'll be facing Manchester United away from home.
Neymar's chest gapped on to try and control it. And they're giving it away. Fantastic. Work, Neymar, fantastic.
Valeri. Bolstinkel.
Through it, thank you. See, that is the only reason you should ever pass back to your keeper is if you get rid of the ball, go straight away. Don't hold on to it. Don't pass around the back.
Here comes the cross. Neymar!
Neymar! Hasn't got the hat trick, he's offside. God damn it.
When he looks back on that, I think he might be a bit disappointed because the striker seemed to time his run really well.
Quick head up.
Coutinho. Neymar? Ah! Oh. He didn't put any lift into the chip. I thought he was trying to chip for the thing where he was, but he didn't put any kind of power into it.
Strong, fair challenge, pulls out for a throw though. Jakob. And the assistant signals for the throw. About Liverpool's next game.
They're playing Crystal Palace in the next match.
Crystal Palace next.
I can only see one winner. I think now coast through.
Johnson. Can they do it in these closing minutes?
Well, it's not going to be a
of course, Palace returning to the Premier League because they got relegated in the first season, bizarrely.
He's moved in, trying to jostle the opponent off his stride.
Although, to be fair, I wouldn't be sad to see him go in real life. Sorry, Crystal Palace fans, but I hate playing you. Because we're fucking cursed against Crystal Palace. And if you could take West Ham with you, by all means do. But West Ham are playing too good. I don't think they're going to get relegated anytime soon.
Quite clearly a free kick. Oh, they're singing the praises.
But pass get relegated,
time ticking away.
Yeah, and to their credit, they really were animated, loud, noisy from the very off here. It's made a difference.
I don't know why he was shooting from there, to be honest with you.
No, if you are going to shoot from that...
Too high, brilliant.
...do a much better job than that. At least make the keeper work.
Bale. He's caught offside.
Coutinho was offside. Can you stay onside, Phil? Now is that too much to ask?
That will be Liverpool's.
You'd think it wouldn't be.
Royce. Another throw here. Stephen Whittaker, Martin Olsen.
Oh, I thought I'd taken the ball there. Coutinho from under pressure.
Basson.
Yes! Oh, I hit it first time! I pressed circle to tackle the ball from him. I didn't think Coutinho would just get it. Neymar's was coming into the box, but Bale decided that his cross would be better, so he hit straight at Roddy. Fantastic work, Gareth.
Marco Royce. Oh, he's through.
Correct. Yes! Correct. Pull one back on Neymar. The gap is back to only two goals. Right, it's more than what it was at the beginning of the game. And it's still not as bad as having it at 3. It could be worse, could have been 4.
For victory, can't really be any comeback in the time that we've got left. With
as it stands, it's only 2. And I mean, Correa is very capable of scoring a hat-trick at any moment, so... and Chelsea did pick up the win against Southampton. They just won't leave me alone. It's very comforting, but if you ask me. Costs as close to 70, better get him up. Alex? But the total is up to 67. Oh, I see who's missing. I was wondering who was missing. It was the, it's my book.
Yeah?
My book? My backup keeper. 7 points clear at Chelsea. So that's disappointing, John. Now there he is. Getting close to the January transfer window as this.
Hi there, Alan Smith. Hi there to everybody from both of us, and welcome to this big match today.
It's Crystal Palace at home.
This is the Liverpool side.
We've failed against them before. It's not that. It's not that. Let's not let that happen again. Straight away, then, Harold Brewster scoring. And it was actually Correa who assisted.
From Neymar, and the keeper's just
interesting.
What a header by the top right.
Good look here again by the replay.
Says a lot about Correa, doesn't it? Maybe he likes a challenge, I don't know. Because it's back to three goals again. Even if Correa did get a hat trick in this match, it would only put them level with each other.
This could be a chance.
Pulled there by Douglas? No? Really?
A very strong.
Interesting choice, referee.
Find the back of the opponent's net, the lowest scoring side.
Your Crystal Palace wanted to let me know. Wanted me to let you know. Your payment will be in the post. So yeah, good luck. Thanks for that. Dumb cunt. Seriously, what the fuck is it? And that was a clear foul. Puts me off the ball.
Here comes the cross. Hit. It's Liverpool who score.
Okay. And now I'm seriously considering they don't give a shit. Neymar has now assisted Correa. I'm not doing this on purpose. This is just how it's working out. I mean, yes, I crossed it in with Neymar. I didn't anticipate it would be Correa who would knock it in. It makes most sense that it's Correa who's knocking it in, considering I played to the front. But
restarting at 2-0.
Speaking of two, it is now back to two.
No doubt about that.
With the gap between Correa and Neymar.
Now it goes into the wider areas where they've got a winger waiting.
This is going to be a repetitive theme throughout the whole season, isn't it?
Well, it's got away from him.
Is Correa going to turn provider again? Neymar. Yes, he is! And it's Neymar again! So it's back to three. Okay, I'm just gonna stop commenting on the top goal scorer race now, because it's getting out of hand.
And they got their reward for it.
Well, you look at the defender on his heels, and you look at the goal scorer. He was on his toes.
We'll see who wins at the end of the season.
Royce. Supporting player alongside. And here's the shot. Well, as blocks go.
Royce wins a corner after all his efforts.
The defender, it will be a corner.
And Varane powers it on. Season, if I'm not mistaken, right? His third. When did he score for another goal?
So they're looking for more.
It's three. Apparently, he has three. I can't remember. Him scoring three. I remember he scored a few episodes ago, but
James,
I don't remember him scoring before that.
Turnover there that we didn't expect. Well, you can see what he was trying to do, but the pass wasn't on. It was a
poor control from Connor Wickham there. Pretty man. And this could be 5-0.
Contest between these two.
Nope. Douglas shoulders him off the ball again.
Leicester from the King Power Stadium and Alan McInally.
It's a goal for Leicester City. 40 minutes played.
Just so you know, shoulder to shoulder is in the free kick. Shouldering into the back of someone? Yeah, that's a foul.
Oh, he's true. He's spotted teammate, and he's got the technique as well as the vision to switch the play. He's just reached it, the goalkeeper.
Neymar hat-trick.
It's a day he'll never forget.
Didn't come off the first time, but he got it the second time asking.
Well, there is a saying that things come in threes. They've come in threes for him, a hat-trick.
Not just three goals, but he's played really well. His overall game has been top class today.
Here's the goal again.
Purely because no Crystal Palace players decided, clear that. No. Apparently everyone is a terrible defender. There's no such thing as a good one in this game. Well, apart from mine, mine are pretty good. Team Chelsea are losing to Leicester. Yes, thank you, Leicester. Leicester doing so. Showing a bit of the form that took him to first in real life.
One team in very good form and another.
I know I saw it up in the corner for a goal from, I think it was Morris. I anticipated Chelsea would have gotten Nicolas. They haven't. Yet. That's just. Yet.
As they build this attack.
That's definitely a corner, anyway.
Neymar's third goal.
What? You gotta be fucking kidding me. I would love to know how the computer paid off the computer. Or is the referee just programmed to absolutely fuck you over? Because this is getting fucking ridiculous now.
The goalkeeper with a textbook save.
He's not calling fouls. He's not giving obvious corners. They're 5-0 down. Crystal Palace are not getting back into this. I don't care if you send off all my players. They're not getting back into this.
Who's at the Etihad Stadium today. Alan, what have you got?
It's a third goal for Manchester City. It's been scored by Kevin De Bruyne. That's his second today. He showed great calmness and composure to tuck away the chance when the move seemed to have broken down on the edge of the area. 58 minutes played, 3-0.
Thank you very much, Alan. What about Crystal Palace and their next game, Alan?
Well, they're playing Manchester United in the next match in the Barclays Premier League. It could be a backs-to-the-wall match for them.
Well, if you look at the coaching manual, you don't defend like that. He's got caught two shots on him.
But for glory, doesn't find anything but over the bar.
James McArthur, he's got that through clever reading of the game, intercepting and getting possession back for his team, Neymar.
A penalty? As if I needed it. At least I got something from this crooked referee. Clearly tricked. No way, he couldn't give the penalty.
Keeping the opposition at bay.
Marco, put away, please. Thank you very much. I like, as soon as I point out that he's not giving me anything, he gives me a penalty. I'm now convinced this game knows I'm. It's fucking with me. And it knows that I know it's fucking with me. And it's inside. Oh shit, he's on to us. Almost always seems to happen as soon as I point. I'm not getting anything from a referee. The referee gives something like a free kick or. In that case, a penalty.
It's not always easy coming into a game and everyone's expecting you to get a hat full, but they've. Kept their focus this side and taken the
make chances. Make that what you will.
It's now with Liverpool.
To the mats. Fail.
The break is definitely on. Good hands, bread and butter work really by the goalkeeper.
Warcraft from Bell. Right. Carlos Rodriguez. Morris. Out of the wing. And a whipping him. Onto the head player.
That's a good cross. A little too eager to get in.
Why did he chest it? For fuck's sake. Oh, he was offside. Is that why he chested it? I mean, I pressed circle, so he should not have chested it. He should have hit it first time. Or with his head or his boot. And it would have been 7-0 had it not been offside. Which is why I'm assuming he hit it. He decided to control it instead of hitting.
Royce.
Foul. Hello, foul. Ah, I kept one penalty, is that it? That's it? That's my limit? Listen. Sorry, right? Just been since.
Marco Royce.
Royce. And the full time whistle's gone.
No doubts today. Right, really.
Lovely. Very dominant performance against Crystal Palace. Be nice if Liverpool could do that in real life once in a while. For anyway, halfway decent against Crystal Palace. Or play good at all against Crystal Palace. Or actually play against Crystal Palace. Or West Ham for that matter. I'm not going to let that go. He don't turn up against those teams. Why? I don't know. If I knew, I try to prevent it. I don't know how I could do that, but I'm sure I could think of something. I'm clever man. Sewell's interceptions are 90. Jesus Christ, I did not know he was that good. I think it's only a matter of time before Sewell gets into the first team. Because he's inches away from 82. Now I put two behind the 14 for rank. Then that would leave me with a difficult decision. Who the hell do I replace? That's not exactly an easy decision. Luckily, it's not a decision I have to make right now. Anyway, thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed. Smash the like button if you did. Subscribe for more videos. And then, until next time, I hope you all have a very